In 1856, James White started to preach and say, we need to understand the cross. And as a result, we will be transformed and we will commit ourselves. And he says, we are not yet committed to God. We go to church, we preach, but we are not fully committed. And therefore, he says, God cannot work through us. And he says, God never changed. He can do the same miracles, he has the same power. But we are not committed as those people were. And he started to preach commitment. You need to see the cross and you need to commit. You need to fully commit. And he says, never doubt God. When you pray, expect. And then she says, expect an answer. When you commit and pray, expect an answer because it will come. Pray in faith. And then she says, to doubt God is to make him a liar. Yeah. And then he started to preach that together with his wife, the two of them. And they started more and more and more people to pray for revival. In that time, in 1856, our church worldwide had 2,500 members, more or less. Very small. Now think about it. One-fifth after those sermons on the cross and commitment. The cross, commitment, praying for the Holy Spirit. The cross, commitment, how can we do it? Praying for the Holy Spirit. Praying for the latter rain. When they started to preach and to pray, one-fifth of the members started to write articles on commitment, on the Holy Spirit and prayer. And the members, one-fifth of our members, started to work. And then he says, as long as we keep praying, the church is going to keep growing. And they started to grow, really grow. And they started to pray in November 56, and they stopped in March 57. So how many months did they pray? November, December, January, February, March. 5 months. Think about it now. She says, when they failed to pray, the work lost its effect, the message lost its power, and the church stopped growing. Now, let me, what she says. When they started to pray in 1856, November, she says, God sent angels in every direction of the world to prepare the hearts for the truth, and if you keep reading, for the second coming. When they started to pray, God sent angels to prepare the world for the second coming. So what happened? When they started to pray, later she says they stopped praying and they are unfitted to receive the latter rain. When they started to pray, Jeremiah Lampier, New York. If you go to New York, close to Central Park, you'll see the building is called Bible Society. And in front of the building is a bench, and on that bench is a copper statue. That's Jeremiah Lampier. He was not a pastor, he was a businessman. When they started to pray, the leadership of the church, and then the members of the church, and it spread all over, and one-fifth of our church was praying and working. Jeremiah Lampier put a placard at the entrance of the Central Park in New York. Every day from 12 noon to 1, come for prayer, everybody is welcome. And they ask him, why do you do that? And he says, I spend time understanding the life of Jesus and the cross of Jesus. And I cannot help but pray and invite people to prayer. You understand? Ellen White says, it would be good for us to spend one thoughtful hour. You remember the quotation? It would be good for us to spend one thoughtful hour every morning reflecting on the last week of Jesus' life and his sacrifice. It would be good for us to spend 1 hour every day reflecting, reading, reflecting, thinking about Jesus' sacrifice. It would change your life. And so, Jeremiah Lampier says, I saw the cross and I cannot help. He invited people to prayer. They were praying from November through March, our church. And instantly, I'm going to show you New York, England, Scandinavia, Australia, East. You remember the quotation, what did he say there? When they started to pray, God sent angels where? All over to prepare the world. When they started to pray, where am I? Here. Okay, Jeremiah Lampier invited people to pray. The first day, 10 people or whatever. Next day, 12 people. Next day, 26 people. I have here the numbers, not important. After 2 weeks of prayer, the bank system collapsed. The economy collapsed. And next day, 10,000 people showed up to prayer. Because when people face trials, they have a tendency to go to God. When the COVID came, churches were filled. When 9/11 came, for 6 months, churches were full. You remember? When people face some type of trials, they go back to God and ask for help. When the economy collapsed, it was only 2 weeks of prayer. 10,000 people came, 10,000 people got converted. And then he says, Jeremiah Lampierre in the history, you can Google it if you want, he says, very interesting, every week another 10,000 got converted for the next several months. Every week 10,000, every week 10,000, every... When you have 10,000 baptisms a week, hello? And he said, over 1 million people got converted in 1 year. And then it spread, I want you to listen carefully to the paragraph, to entire US, Canada, Brazil, Chile, United Kingdom, England, Central Europe, South Africa, India, Australia, and New Zealand. And it took code all over the world. When people pray, God sent angels ready for the second coming. But then what happened? What happened? What happened? Very strange. The government gave free land to those who want to start a farm. More ships with immigrants came to New York and they found gold in California. And she says, our people stopped praying and some got lands for free to start farms and some went for gold. And some took immigrants that was cheap labor for their businesses. And they were too busy with their business and they stopped praying and the work stopped growing. And Jesus didn't come. And then she says, they were not worth for the latter rain yet. People got distracted. Satan knew exactly what to give them and they got distracted. They said, free land. You follow me? Gold. And they stopped praying. And that's the reason. Jesus could have come long ago, but yet we are not ready.